We are back. Happy New Year, everybody. Maniac here. I'm still a little hoarse. And so I don't know how long I'll be able to stream this because I'm not feeling 100% just yet. But I know everybody has been asking me, when are you going to finish up Uncharted? When are you going to finish up Uncharted? Because there have been two things that have been actually said to me. When I announced I was going to do Uncharted 2, Uncharted 3 after Uncharted, everybody was fine with that. Everybody was great with that. But when I announced that I was thinking about after finishing Uncharted 3 to start playing Final Fantasy X, my Twitter exploded with likes. And I'm somebody who never gets any likes whatsoever on Twitter. So if I get one or two likes, I consider that exploded. So, yeah, that was surprising. So, we're going to do it. You know, we're going to do it. I have plans for what I'm going to do with Final Fantasy X, so there's an update there. But I'm definitely going to play Uncharted 2 and Uncharted 3 first. And then we'll get to Final Fantasy X later. But this is a huge backlog. I've never had this many games backlogged to me. Usually I'll just have a game in mind, and maybe I'll do it, maybe I won't, but usually when I'll finish up a game, or I'll play a game, or I'll demo a game. Sorry about this, this is just my loading screen. Hopefully you guys can still hear me, I know you can't see me. I'm just setting up a save game, and I think we're back. Okay, this is my favorite of the Uncharted games, just want to say that right now. I think it's the best Uncharted game. I did not tell half of what I saw, for I know I would not be believed. Marco Polo, on his deathbed, 1324. Did not tell half of what I saw, for what I saw could not be believed. This opening is one of the best in gaming history. That's first off.
What's going on?
What's with the rope?
That's my blood. That's my blood. It's a lot of my blood.
Oh boy, here we are. This is one of the best openings in video game history right here. I love this opening. Why? I mean, they used it as a demo for one of the early previews for this game. But, you know, the thing I loved so much about it is that you still got the sense of adventure. It still felt like very true to the Uncharted formula, very true to Uncharted games. I can't move that far. Here you go, this way. There we go. Oh boy. And plus, unlike the previous games, this is just so dynamic, this scene. I mean, it's a tutorial, yes, but it doesn't feel like one. I mean, I remember playing this opening and thinking, wow, this game is freaking awesome. This is what a great opening. And I was also thinking, boy, I hope Nate's okay. And then I was thinking as this scene is going on, I'm just like, this guy just can't catch a break.
It's okay. Come on.
Yeah, because, like, seriously, every time I try to get a little bit closer... I guess I didn't have enough momentum on that jump. Oh, and I'm all the way back here, seriously? Sorry about that instant death, guys. Now, this is once again going to be a 100% completion attempt. So, what's going to happen is that I'm going to try to get every treasure and as many trophies as I can get, given the difficulty that I'm on right now. And the reason I am playing on easy difficulty, there's a reason for that, particularly because I if I'm going to do a treasure hunt, I prefer to do that on the easiest difficulty. Because it does, you know, the treasures will carry over to the other at least in these games it does, in Uncharted 4 it doesn't. And in The Last of Us it doesn't.
It's okay. It's okay.
Let's try this again. Oh my god. And once again, I fall to my death. Did I go too far? I must have gone too far. Ah, now I'm back here again. Sorry, guys. But back to what I was saying, basically. My frustration with the scene aside... I'm just playing a bathroom right now. This is such, this really is a great scene. Okay, let's try this one more time. But yeah, I prefer to do the trophy. This is one thing I was really mad about for, like, the... I always feel obligated to get all the trophies and get, you know, this is just how I am. This is what kind of gamer I am. And so I always appreciated when games would be like... No, you've already collected them, and you don't want to collect them again. So you've already collected them, so you don't have to collect them again on subsequent playthroughs, unless you either delete the save or you create a you create a new save or something on a new profile. Oh, thank goodness. I do like that they carried over everything. That was what I appreciated so much. And that they made, climbing and everything so dynamic here. Even with... We're good. I mean, you can just tell there's just so much polish in this, you know, my screw up aside. There's just so much polish in this sequence, and yet all the movements and everything feel so fluid. They feel like, for somebody who's played the first Uncharted game, like you're basically right back at home, basically. But in another... aspect or another respect of that, it feels like it's improved in a lot of ways. Let's see if I can do this. Come on, you know you want to. Let's go, Nate. I mean, just look at this environment. Come on, Nate, move. We made it. Oh, maybe not. Come on, Nate. Hello. Not the kind of environment I was expecting.
Buy me a drink, sailor.
Harry Flynn? Hey! What the hell are you
I doing? Love this actor. I'm Steve Valentine, ladies and gentlemen.
Should I be flattered or worried?
Maybe a bit of both.
Maybe it's his accent I love so much, but I love this guy.
Job for us.
Really?
Client is willing to part with a huge sum of cash if we acquire a certain object for him.
Right, I'm listening.
Now, you're not gonna like this.
Oh no. No, you're out of your mind.
Yeah, just hear me out for a second.
Flynn, we both know two people who were killed trying to lift something out of this
and
place.
And one who made it out.
Yeah, barely.
I can't do this without you, Drake. You're the only one who's cracked it, and you know better than anyone it's a two-person job.
No. Three, actually.
Right. And speak of the devil, here she comes now.
What? Chloe Fraser.
Nate. Drake. Nathan. Drake.
Claudia Black, ladies and gentlemen.
Chloe is one of the best drivers in the business. She'll take good care of us.
I bet.
Right, look. I've got it all figured out. We go in through the sewer.
I'm loving it so far.
That puts us in the courtyard. From there, we scale up the wall, run across the rooftops, and just drop down into the exhibit hall. Bob's your uncle. And what is worth all this trouble, I hear you ask?
I didn't, but go ahead. But that's it. An oil lamp.
Yeah.
It's worthless. I don't get it.
Neither do we. That's why we tracked you down.
Well, it sounds like you're working for a nutcase. Some collector who's got too much time and money on his hands. And by the way, this is not worth any of it.
But there's more. How's your 13th century Latin, mate?
Where'd you get this?
Borrowed it from the files of the nutcase.
In Trebizond, we were set upon by thieves. Father, Maffeo, and I were robbed of our greatest treasures. This was written by Marco Polo.
Yes, that much we were able to work out.
Unfortunately, the rest of it's nonsense.
Hey, hold on. So that it should not fall into the wrong hands, I concealed my great sorrow in the unlikeliest place. The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
See what I mean? It's just gibberish.
He's talking about the lost fleet.
Yeah.
I know. Someone want to fill me in?
Marco Polo leaves China with 600 passengers and 14 ships loaded down with treasure from Kublai Khan. Now he lands in Persia a year and a half later with only one ship left and only 18 passengers. Now he recorded every detail of his journey, but he never told what happened to all those ships and the passengers.
So somewhere out there are 13 ships loaded with the Emperor's treasure waiting to be found.
Yeah, and that is what your client is after. Look at this lamp. It's covered in Mongolian script. It must have been a gift from Kublai Khan.
The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
Marco Polo hid something inside this lamp. Something that pinpoints the site of the lost fleet.
You guys just got your history lesson for today, and let me tell you something. That's awesome.
Over,
right?
Damn straight.
Absolutely. You in then?
What the hell? I mean, what could possibly go wrong?
As far as I know, most of that information about what happened to Marco Polo is factual. Now, the game takes some liberties on what happened to Marco Polo after those events or during those events, that what he found and everything else. So let's not beat around the bush, but the information about Marco Polo coming back with Kublai Khan from China, as far as I know, is completely accurate, at least as far as we know in history. They might have fudged a couple of things for simplicity's sake, but got the first treasure. Nice. Yeah, you might notice here right now, wow, this snow looks incredible. Remember how I said in the first game, the developers at Naughty Dog really had to work really hard to get the water effects to work so well. Oh boy. Here, they were trying to basically recreate snow, or basically do something so that snow could be this game's version of water. And I think they succeeded, I really do. I mean, look at this snow, it moves dynamically. This looked so much better on PS3. I gotta give them that. Okay, there should be a trophy right over, here it is. Okay, let's grab this. Okay. Cool.
Of course it's locked.
It's always locked. Is it? Because we're in a cliche, Nate. Yeah, we are. And that is the third treasure. Let's inspect it. A Tibetan snuff bottle. A Sarwasati statue. And a wrathful deity statue. That's really interesting. Now, what I was trying to say before about everybody was that, as far as I know, all that stuff is pretty much accurate to the games. It's like really nothing, or at least accurate to history. Like I said, they did take some liberties, but the thing that I really liked about the Uncharted games in particular was that you really did, you know, you really did need some kind of historical something or other.
He's alive.
To grasp onto. And that was just, that's just a testament and a tribute to Amy Hennig's, you know, careful work and planning, basically, because you can't just make something like that up entirely. It's got to be based on something realistic. And for me personally, this is my favorite legend. There, I said it. Maybe it's because I come from an Italian heritage and I love Marco Polo and the stories about Marco Polo. So maybe that's just me. I totally acknowledge that, but more climbing. Really hiding these treasures really far. I think this might be the last treasure in the area, but just let me double check. This is the thing that's basically, it's like I'm gonna try to find every single treasure. And of course, no, it's not the last treasure in this area. Where's the last? It's like I thought there was only gonna be like three or four treasures in this area. It turns out there's like a dozen. Let's see. So what I was saying is, like, I love Marco Polo. I remember telling the story about, you know, from this game, based upon the legend, to my father years ago when this game first came out. And and my father was like, is this true? This can't be true. I said, Dad, that's the legend. We don't know for certain if it's true. These are just the assumptions that some, or theories, I should say, that some people have made. Basically, the understanding about what Marco Polo did after he met Kublai Khan, things he said, he died, you know, he admitted this, he died saying he didn't write down half of what he saw because he didn't think anybody would believe him. And that's all accurate. We know that Marco Polo kept a lot of that stuff to himself, or at least he had said it. Yeah. So, I gotta give a tribute to Amy Hennig, certainly, just flat out, for doing her research about this. I guess I'm out. Am I dead? Oh, there it goes.
Hello. Well, so much for foreplay.
You mind telling me what the hell is going on?
You mean with Flynn?
Yeah. You might have warned me.
And missed the look on your face? Anyway, you haven't exactly made yourself easy to find.
Talk about making yourself easy.
Oh, you're not jealous. Let's not forget who walked out on whom. After all, you don't get to be jealous.
Wait a minute, Chloe.
If it makes you feel any better, my relationship with Flynn is strictly professional.
Really?
Mostly professional.
Oh.
When I figured out he was actually on to something, I thought you'd want to be in on the action.
So what's the plan?
Just like we said, we pull the heist, we find the ships, and we make off with the treasure.
With Flynn?
Mm-hmm.
And then?
And then we split the take three ways, and you and I just disappear. Together this time.
I see.
Until then,
He can't know about us.
He's gonna be pissed.
He's gonna be fine. Trust me.
Okay. Claudia Black was told when they were blocking this scene, because she had a motion capture this scene with the guy who plays Nathan Drake, that she didn't actually have to kiss him. Now, Claudia Black is married in real life, and she did not kiss him. Oh, guess I'm alive now. I guess I had to move. I see. But the funny thing is that Claudia Black came into this game, you know, she wasn't obviously cast immediately because, you know, this is the second game. She wasn't in the first game. Like, the actors from the first game were immediately cast. And so the new actors that came in, like, Steve Valentine and Claudia Black, basically, were coming in after the fact. And so they knew what their limitations were. They knew what they had to do. And Claudia admitted that all she really felt like she had to do was she had to win over the actor that plays Nathan Drake. She had to win over Nolan North. And she figured that if she could win over Nolan North or get his support, then she had something. And the next treasure is over here. And Nolan North, you know, was like, yes, and you did your performance topless, which I thought was perfect. Of course, that probably wasn't true, so we don't know exactly what she did. But when I watch scenes like that about how willing she is to just be out there, that, fearless, basically, I get that kind of fearless feeling from her, at least in these performances. It's so interesting and exciting to see, well, what did she do to get that, you know, she really did have to turn in one heck of a performance to get that role. So, props to her for that. As for Steve Valentine, I'll talk about him more when we get a little bit further on in the game. Okay. Finally made it out of the train. Found the Perpa. Ladies and gentlemen, the Tolku and the Shadow are really gonna miss this thing.
For this. I'd feel a lot better if I had a gun. You won't need them. A little insurance, that's all. Flynn, they're just museum guards. And we have their patrols all mapped out. Relax.
Relax? Relax. Have you ever been in a Turkish prison, mate? If we get caught, they will lock us up and throw away the sodding key. You do realize that, don't you?
Better than you do.
Well, you may fancy that kind of thing, but I don't. Can't afford to make any mistakes.
Yeah, and we won't.
We're here.
This way.
So what do we do if they switch the patrols?
Figure it out as we go.
We cannot fumble our way through this.
I don't fumble. I improvise.
Oh, is that what you call it?
Yeah. I'm adaptable.
Adaptable?
You cocky bastard.
There. What did I tell you? That passage there is going to take us right under the museum.
You called it, all right.
You need to have a little more faith in me, chum.
Okay. This one here is me.
All right, remember, that tower is our only way into the exhibit. But we can't even get close with those floodlights on.
We've gone over this.
Just make sure you cut the power by the time we reach the second courtyard.
The lights will be out. I'll have the van waiting at the rendezvous point. Just make sure you get your asses out of there in time.
Fair enough.
All right, enough chat. Let's do this.
Chloe. See you on the other side.
Looking forward to it.
You sure you know where you're going?
Don't I always?
And now this wonderful water's back. So as for this guy, we're going to be co-oping with him for this level. I do love that they carried over the water effects for this game.
It's like the good old days, isn't it?
Yeah. When were those again?
So let's talk about Steve Valentine for a second. We already talked about Claudia Black. Steve Valentine is a comedian and actor. I loved him in shows like Crossing Jordan. He also appeared, most people will probably remember him, at least his biggest, most famous role was probably, the biggest role most people would recognize him from was he was the, he played the photographer in Spider-Man 3 that said, hey, he was photographing Gwen in her modeling sequense. He right. said to her, hi, Gwen, I have a secret. Now this is what you're thinking. I have a secret, and it's my copia. Hey.
Now, what do you bet that will take us right into the boiler room? And from there, we're in.
Yeah, in like Flynn, right?
What?
In like Flynn.
I don't get it.
Just give me a boost.
I love that they brought these co-op mechanics back. I remember these co-op mechanics from, obviously, the first Uncharted game. Obviously, we did it with, you know, Sully's character, of course, in the earlier games. But this, I thought, made for a really nice way of showing characters the ropes.
You ready? No guts, no glory.
Without actually having to make it feel like it's hand-holding.
We're good.
Okay, there should be a... Here it is. Nice. I have no idea what that is, but it looks like a Spanish coin or something. It's pretty cool. Alright, so that's treasure number 6. There is a treasure number 7 here somewhere. So back to what I was saying about Steve Valentine. Another show I really liked that he did was he did this game show a couple years ago. I think it was on the Sci-Fi channel. I don't remember the name of it. But what I really liked about it, what he basically played a guy who was living in a mansion, or who's in charge of a mansion, basically caretaking a mansion. And so you had to be in the mansion and do kinds of crazy fear trials and stuff like that. And I really liked it. I thought it was a good show. Mostly because of him. I thought the show, which made the show so great, was that Valentine was doing such a good job being... playing like the scary recluse. He was just having so much fun in the role, basically. He just really was. And like I said, at that point, I remembered him as playing the crazy, I only remembered him from Crossing Jordan at that point. So.
All right. This is the way to the courtyard.
But not to the treasure. We're going to get a treasure right over here. Yes, you want to give me the precious... Nice. The glass evil eye. Thought only women gave you the evil eye. That was a Byzantine coin. Okay. So, that immediately scored points with me there. Obviously, I recognized him from when this game came out, I immediately recognized his voice, and I was like, oh, they got that actor. Really disappointed they never brought him back, or at least, it would have been awesome to see him come back for another role. But I think he was just so recognizable that I don't think they could have brought the actor back unless they brought him back for this role specifically. So, and since they didn't bring the character back for the other games, at least not as far as I remember, not including, I've never played Uncharted's, Golden Abyss.
Well, we're not going this way. Not if you want to keep your skin.
All right. There's got to be a shutoff valve around here somewhere.
See if you can find it then.
This is cool.
You got it.
Close enough. Yep. So it's weird playing this game. Like I said, I'm used to... When I first played this game, I'm getting flashbacks to when I first played it years and years and years ago when it first came out. And I was just thinking about, well, how different was my setup back then? It's like, I just want you to know, like, how much of a just incredible difference it is for me to play the game like this. You know, when I played this game for the first time, it was on a 24-inch computer monitor, actually. I remember back in the day, I didn't have my big screen television that I'd been playing my games on until around 2010 or so. Before that, I was mostly just playing my my Wii. And my Xbox One and my PlayStation 3 games on my 24-inch computer monitor.
Now there should be a door just around this corner. That's our access point. Once we're through, just stick to the plan. You got me?
I mean, it's a great monitor, don't get me wrong. I love it. It was a nice 16x10. It was top of the line when I got it. The color on it, however, wasn't the world's greatest, but it could do 1080p. It could do 1920x1080, 1920x1200. It had composite component, you know. Nice ring. It had composite component and everything else, you know, up things and things I really liked about it. But the problem that I had with it was that it just didn't have great color vibrancy. Like my TV and probably on your computer monitors nowadays, even cheap monitors nowadays have really good color. And so it's really disappointing for me to, you know, to look at my monitor nowadays. And most of the time nowadays, I just use it for computer work. I don't use it for really anything else. And so, let's see, where's the next trophy? Oh, that one's going to be fun to get. Oh, boy.
It's locked.
Good job I came prepared. I pick more than my nose, my friend.
Oh, wait. There's an alarm. Oh, that's new since last time.
Great. Now what?
Well, I can disarm it if we can find the junction box.
I would make a joke about how any, you know, expert with any type of technical expertise or installing something like this would hide it, and then I realized this is so obviously a retrofit. That I don't know if you could, because, you know, nowadays any security system like this would be buried in a wall. And it's like, it's so, you know, it would be so obvious to disarm. But, okay. I don't see a junction box over here.
Why don't you follow the conduit?
Trying to follow it. Back behind there. Oh, there it is.
There. That ought to do it.
All right, we're in.
So yeah, you'll have to basically stick things on top of other things, and I'm just like, well, what's the point of having an alarm if it's so obvious to, you know, to deploy?
I got him.
Or it's so obvious to defeat, I should say.
From here. We're gonna have to make our way to the next courtyard, through that gate over there.
Well, let's do it.
I can't get out of this. Let me try resetting. The heck? Where am I supposed to transition to? I don't see anything. I'm holding circle.
We've got to get up to that balcony. We can climb the gate over here. Got it.
Yeah, that should do it, I think.
Arkasında çalışmaktan nefret ediyorum.
I've got the other one.
Haklısın abi. Hiçbir şey yok.
Okay.
Ödeyen ne zaman bitiyor? Daha çok. 15 dakikaya kadar bitiyor.
Come on. What are you waiting for?
This is where there's a treasure in this area over here.
Okay. I'll go right. You go left.
All right, he's out. I think there's a treasure here. There it is. And that is a tough treasure to get because of all the guys in this area, but it looks like Nathan, it looks like I got a little bit of backup from Harry, from Valentine. Okay. There's another, I'm looking for another, like I said, this kind of area is a little bit tougher because it's a stealth area. And so because of that, getting treasure and stuff like that in the stealth area kind of sucks, but it's not impossible. Alright, let's move on. Looking for a fountain. There's a treasure in a fountain.
Okay. We should be able to lift this up. Sneak right under.
Whoa! Whoa! Not so fast. There's another alarm.
Oh, great. You want to get this one? Wait here.
Okay. It's up there, I think. See if I can climb this. Let's climb it. We're climbing.
Okay. It's off.
Somebody's looking. Alright, he's not looking anymore.
Alright. One, two, three.
Alright, go.
You got it.
Yeah. Hurry.
Okay. Go. Alright.
That gate looks heavy.
Hurry up.
Easy.
I think this is a fountain area.
Right.
Could be wrong.
You gotta cross this courtyard to get onto the roof.
Okay, I'll just let you do all the asking.
Okay, there it is. There's the treasure.
Head to the fountain.
Okay. I am really screwing around there. Silver belt buckle, everybody. Let's see, is there anything else I can do over here? Like, I can't take that guy out because he's against something, and apparently the game won't let me just grab him. Is there anybody else left? Let's see. I think I'm good for right here. Sorry about these pauses. The problem is like when you're trying to get, you know, a game like this and you're trying to get everything all set up, it's impossible. Like, it's been so many years since I first tried to play this that... wasn't right. Let's take him out. Is he gonna move? That guy's not moving. That guy's not moving.
He? Müze kapalı. Kuştu.
Köşeye sıkıştırın.
That's kind of BS. You shouldn't have heard me. All right.
Damn it.
I moved too fast. He saw me. Now, this is frustrating. Well, I know there's a sequence to this. I just gotta learn it. I never liked stealth gameplay. I don't think anybody did. The reason why is because the AIs can never be programmed correctly. Anytime you want to turn around, buddy.
Kaçmaya çalışma. Düştü!
Durdur onu!
I tried grabbing that the other guy. He wouldn't let me. All right, let's try this one more time. I screwed up. All right, this will be it. I think what's going to happen is I have to take this guy out.
Night, night.
How do you see me?
Head for the fountain.
God, I am terrible at this game today. Sorry about this, guys. It's kind of exciting to see this. Maybe if I go this way, maybe?
Lights out. Ah, shit.
Too visible? What if I go in the fountain? It's like you gotta basically map this whole thing out. It's like there's only like one sequence this game wants, but there's so many guards, and they're completely locked into their programming. So you have to know exactly what the sequence is. It's in my case, it's taken me a couple of attempts because I don't know the sequence. Let's try this. Maybe this will work. No, it doesn't work. Oh, there it goes.
Sweet dreams.
All right, here's two more guards. If I'm correct, that guy's not going to move. And that guy's not going to move either. Oh, good. Harry got him. Sweet, I got a Bare Knuckle Brawler award.
Now we just got to find a way up to that window.
Which window? There's a lot of bloody windows.
Okay, let's move on. Oh, Harry. Okay. But the thing that I liked about it is I've watched interviews with Steve Valentine and with the rest of the cast basically together. Sorry, I'll hold that thought.
Oh, crap. Now what?
It's time to tip the odds back in our favor.
Oh, that's brilliant. Guns? What are you thinking?
Relax, Gandhi. They're tranquilizer guns. Totally non-lethal. Your conscience will remain unscathed.
Oh, well. Good idea.
Great. Okay, a little bit of advice. These things have lousy range, so we still have to get in close. You okay with that?
Know how to shoot a gun, genius.
Let's take these guys out.
Bu kutulara bizim taşımamızı beklemiyorlar umarım. Bu bizim görevimiz değil ki.
Bunlar ne ki zaten?
Bizde kapalı.
Grab him.
Yakalayın onu.
I'm out of range. I shot him out of range. I should have gotten closer.
Let's take these guys out.
Eski sergiden kalan eşyalar. Depoya gidiyorlar.
Bana çerçöp gibi geldi daha çok.
Alright.
Çık ortaya.
Thanks, Harry.
We gotta get up to that walkway.
All right, I think we got it.
This could help.
I do like that they brought these mechanics back.
Okay, for something with wheels, this is very heavy.
So I was saying about the... this is the reason why I really wanted to see him back, is because... he really had... watching interviews with him and with the director, Gordon Hunt, and with Claudia Black and everything, it was so obvious that these guys got along so well.
Good thing one of us thought ahead, eh?
All yours.
Yeah, Uncharted 4. We can't have our own grappling hook. The system the PS3 system can't support. Yeah, I'm not kidding, actually.
Hey, lad, you got it.
Should be good. Okay, moving on. So like I was saying, the repertoire with the actors between everybody, even the old school and the new school guys, was just so well done that I really had to give props to the... I really had to give props to the team for it. You know, they had their little brotherhood, and they let him in, and... he really got along with everybody. Now, maybe it's just because he's a funny guy in real life, because he is. He really is funny in real life. So he must have like one of those personalities that everybody seems to love, but... And we got it. Is this the last one in this area? But yeah, I would totally recommend, if you can, to look up on PlayStation Network or on the PlayStation YouTube channel the interviews with the motion capture crew. For the Uncharted 2. They actually published them on the PlayStation Network, the video files for them, but they may no longer be available. But if they are, I totally recommend checking them out because they were just so funny. It's just so funny. And then on top of that, they also had Gordon Hunt in them, who directed the motion capture for this game. And, well, let me tell you about how I felt about Gordon Hunt, the late Gordon Hunt. He died recently, unfortunately. I kind of thought... when I was watching this, because the interviews were between the main cast, obviously, Richard McGarnacle, Emily Rose, Claudia Black, Nolan North, but Steve Valentine, obviously, was there, and Robin Atkin-Downs, of course. And the thing that I really liked about it was that they also had Amy Henning there, and they had Gordon Hunt there. And obviously Amy Henning was there, that she was the writer, of course, so she had a lot that she could contribute to the story, obviously. But Gordon Hunt was the director. Now, the thing that I liked about Gordon Hunt was that it was obvious to me after, you know, just looking at the guy, he just kind of came across as like, this guy is one of those classically trained directors. You know, he's the kind of guy that you had in mind when you're watching, like, you know, an old like Hollywood documentary from the 1930s or something.
Right, there's the tower.
Getting closer.
Appreciate that update, Captain Obvious.
Let's see, is there anything over here? Yeah, there is. Wow.
Don't look down.
All right, this is a great scene. But yeah, the thing I liked about Gordon Hunt was that he really impressed me in the fact that he was so clearly an old school theater director or stage director or film director. And I'm just like, wow, it is so awesome that his skills, you know, his skills honed over, you know, all these years could be adapted for this medium.
Oh, gotcha. Pull me up. You pull him. Wait, pull me up.
That's just funny.
That was close.
All right, no more donuts for you.
Hey, everybody loves donuts. Boy knows I do. I love that song, Everybody Loves Donuts. Okay. It's like, I want the grappling hook. Yeah. You mean to tell me I have to wait two more games, technically three, to get my own grappling hook?
I'm right behind you.
As always.
Yep, that's what I thought. This one's really sneaky. Got it. What would a treasure be doing there? Like, seriously, like, what would a treasure be doing there? Did somebody, like, have the treasure and then drop it down a drain or something and then it got stuck in the trap? And nobody wanted to go out there because of how difficult it was. That's the only conclusion I could come up with. Did somebody accidentally drop one down a storm drain or something? I don't know. Who knows? Alright, so apparently there are more. There's another one in this chapter. A lot of freaking treasures in this chapter, let me tell you. Looks like this one might be a bit easier to find. No, I guess not. Alright, moving on.
There's a guy above you.
I love that scene.
This guy below.
Okay, that's a great joke. I love that joke. That's a great joke. Wow, they really increased the detail here. I mean, the map painting obviously looks, you know, it. Wow. All right, Harry, I'm going with you because you don't even know where you're going. I don't think this is the way. That's the way I came in. Where am I going? Maybe I climb this? Oh yeah, there we go. Yeah.
Great view. I can see your house. Let's get moving.
All right, we're doing well.
There's a guard right below you.
And he's out.
Nearly there.
Yeah, but why are the lights still on?
Chloe will take care of it, don't worry.
Okay, next treasure should be somewhere over here. There it is. And once again, it's in a weird position. A nice pocket watch, although, let me be honest, this is hardly... It's an antique pocket watch, but it doesn't look... super duper new or super duper old. It just looks like a pocket watch. That's kind of cool looking though. I think my grandfather had a pocket watch like that, but it was a bit more detailed. You know, watches, they're difficult to maintain. I think there's like one more in this section. It's not here. I think I should be okay for the rest of this area. Let's just follow Flynn, see where he goes. Head for the tower. Oh, there's the tower. All right.
order.
Okay, did not see that guard. Glad I did.
Shit. We can't get any closer with the tower lit up like that. What the hell's she doing?
Come on, Chloe.
He could just use a pinch.
That's my girl.
And here it is. We got to the tower. Looks like Flynn got it. We got it. I think we got it. It should be in here somewhere.
Okay. We're clear.
This is exciting.
Ladies first. Cute.
I wonder how much slash fic has been written between these two guys. I don't even want to think about it. But you know what? I think their actors would be flattered by the slash fic. It's just the vibe I get. These guys have great senses of humor, so I'm sure that if there's slash fic about these two, I'm sure the actors would love it. So write all you want, fanboys and fangirls.
Go off. We so much as touch this glass.
No worries, mate. Voila. Now we're sure it's the right one.
Well, I guess there's only one way to find out. Sorry, Marco. Crap.
Well, that's the understatement of the year.
This is it. It's bloody useless. The light of the Great Khan. Wait a minute. What are you doing? It's resin. It'll burn.
And?
Just give me your lighter.
Is that really a good idea in here?
Man. Whoa. Let me see that. Our ships were driven by a great flood tide. Into the wilds of Java.
Sounds like they were hit by a tsunami.
Yeah, somewhere off the west coast of Borneo.
Oh, great. That narrows it down a bit.
Look, this mountain must have been the closest landmark where they went aground. We find that mountain. We find the ships.
Yeah, good work, mate.
Wait, there's more. Okay, Joe. As if the ocean itself sought to throw off the terrible cargo we carried from Shambhala.
That's my Wi-Fi password!
Would that mean something to you?
Shambhala. It's not.
Oh my god, Flynn.
What?
Marco Polo found Shambhala. Shangri-La.
You're joking.
If they were carrying the Jintamani stone, it might still be there.
It's all very fascinating, but we really gotta go.
Yeah, I'm right behind you. The hell are you doing?
Sorry, mate. This is where we part ways.
Wait, Flynn, we had a plan.
No, you had a plan. Turns out I've got one of my own.
Come on, throw me the rope. Don't be stupid.
Oh, yeah, right. You're the mastermind. Only you overlooked one little detail. Didn't you, partner?
So what are you gonna do, shoot me now?
No, I just need you out of the way for a little while.
Shit.
You think I didn't know about the ships from the beginning? Any schoolboy could have figured that out.
Flynn, listen.
Face it, genius. You've been played. Not yet. Want to give the guards a decent head start. Right, that's my cue. No hard feelings, yeah?
We got a problem. Let's move.
Flynn.
Got it.
Hemen çıkışları kapatın.
Kapıyı kapatın.
Let's keep moving.
No. Gah. Crap.
All right. Think, Nate. Think. Yeah, there it is.
All right, we're good.
Yeah, this way, this way.
I love these run sequences, though.
Use your head, mate. Use your head.
I'm laying on
us. Get out of here.
That's it. That's the last trophy in this area.
Aşağıda.
Yakalayın onu.
Yeah, gotta go this way over here.
There we go. Gotta get to that ladder.
I think we got it.
See ya, suckers.
Freedom! Freedom!
You overlooked one little detail, didn't you, partner?
3 months later.
Face it, genius, you've been played.
Oh, really?
Hey, hey, hey! Jackass, you're ruining the show here.
Ah, what a shame.
Sully!
Pick the goddamn Sullivan! Alone for a
minute. Oh, man, am I glad to see you.
How you doing, kid?
I'm doing just great.
So, had to grease a few palms. Did go through the rest of your money. And a good chunk of my own, but... Hey. Jesus, you stink.
Yeah, not half as bad as that cigar. Yeah. Hey, how'd you find me?
Well, a friend of yours asked for my help.
Hello, Nate.
Oh, aw, Chloe's
no,
back.
I'll wait a second.
Sully, kick her out and shut the door. We're safer in here.
Just wait a goddamn minute. Hear her out.
Thank you, Victor.
Hey, no offense, Sully, but you're not exactly the best judge of character, especially when it comes to women.
Fair enough. All the same.
Dear God.
Oh, no, it's not that bad. Look, I have my own bucket. Last cell I was in, 8 of us had to share.
Listen, Nate.
You know something? I really appreciate you dropping by, but if you and Flynn hadn't screwed me over in the first place, I wouldn't
minute.
Have been rotting in this shithole for
Listen,
the last three
Nate.
Months. So excuse me if I'm not just, you know, leaping into your arms.
I had nothing to do with it.
Right.
I told you, he's not going to listen to me.
Screw this. Nate, they found the ships.
In Borneo?
Yes.
And the Chintamani stone?
How do you know about that?
Do you really think Flynn could have figured that out on his own?
All right, good point. No, they haven't found it yet.
What do you mean they?
Flynn and his client, Lazarevich.
You know, the nutcase. They've been working together all along.
All right, then. If they haven't found the stone, that means there's still time. You're gonna get us into that dig site. We are gonna snatch that treasure right out from under them.
They'll never see it coming.
Yeah, well, payback's a bitch. Look, they called it the wish-fulfilling jewel. It's a sacred object.
What, like a Buddhist holy grail?
Exactly.
Thanks.
Sully, listen to this. In the kingdom of Shambhala lies the most precious thing to be found in all the world. A perfect raw sapphire of the deepest blue, larger around than the reach of a man's arms.
Ooh, that's gotta be worth millions.
And you said
Sully likes it.
Loads more. Lazarevich paid top dollar for Marco Polo's journals. He's been after the Chintamani stone for years.
Well, if he's been counting on Flynn to find it for him, it's no wonder he hasn't had any luck.
If I can get a look at Lazarevich's files, I can find that stone.
Hang on a minute, cowboy. That's easier said than done. The files are in his tent, and his tent is in the middle of the camp. It's like an armed compound. There are soldiers everywhere.
Well... that's why it has to be an inside job. From someone they know and trust.
Oh. Okay, I see where this is going.
I just need a diversion. You give me 5 minutes in that tent, that's all it'll take.
Really? 5 minutes? Well, that's great. I won't even have to get my top off.
Chloe, I was thinking more like an explosion.
Or that.
Oh!
Are you in?
Oh, hell yes. I was in before you were.
8 years. I completely that one went right over my head 8 years ago. So yeah.
You reading us?
Loud and clear.
We're getting close.
We're gonna take a little break here.
Okay.
We're at chapter 3.
All around the perimeter of the camp. You two just need to arm them. The first one should be right ahead of you.
We're gonna, like I said, we're gonna end the stream just here right now, and we're gonna take a quick break, and I will be back later today. Please subscribe, Maniac536. Please visit my website, GameAccess.net, and hopefully you guys enjoyed the stream, and yeah, we will be getting back to this later today. So thanks for watching, guys.